A most well-known medical practitioner was born on 18th August 1938 in Pangla, Udupi. He has MBBS from Stanley Medical College, Madras, MD from King George Medical College, Lucknow, FRCP from Royal College of Physicians, London, Glasgow, Edinburgh and Dublin. He also has a FSCC and FAMS. He has received training in cardiology from Harvard Medical School. B.M. Hegde is a cardiologist, medical scientist, educationist and author. He is the former Vice-Chancellor of Manipal University and Chairman of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Mangalore. He has authored several books on medical practice and ethics. He is also the Editor-in-Chief of the Medical Journal, Journal of the Science of Healing Outcomes. He was awarded the Dr. B.C. Roy Award in 1999 and in 2010, he was honored with the Padma Bhushan, one of the India's highest. We are very happy to have you here, sir, as a keynote speaker. I would like to request Dr. B.M. Hegde to address the gathering.
Topic is very interesting. Illness to wellness. It's very simple. Illness starts with I. And wellness starts with we. That's all. You convert yourself from the I of your arrogance to we of your compassion. You become well. You become healthy. That's the essence of yoga. It makes you from your I to your we. It makes you a good human being. That's all what yoga is all about. Name it what you like. You go to America, there are 63 schools of yoga. Starting from Usha yoga to hot yoga and things like that. Everybody gives a name and starts it because it's a big money spinner there. So, yoga is something which is a part of your life, like breathing. If you know how to breathe well, if you know how to breathe properly, if you know how to convert yourself from the sympathetic breathing pattern to the parasympathetic breathing pattern, you not only become a yogi, you become a healthy person. See? This is how a dog breathes when it runs and comes. But you see a yogi breathes. You don't even know whether he's breathing or not because it's a belly button breathing. You just push your diaphragm down using the vagus and enlarge your lungs and push your abdominal organs down. And then bring it back without any effort at all. A lot of yoga teachers teach yoga in a very funny way. I saw the other day, I went to inaugurate a yoga place somewhere, I won't tell you where. There he was teaching. I said that is becoming more sympathetic than the normal breathing. So I showed them how to breathe. It's very important. Now remember one thing, before you understand yoga, you must understand science. The science that you learned in school and college is a reductionist Western science. That is not the worldview now. It's not Newton and Einstein's worldview. It's a new worldview called the quantum worldview, which says the whole world is energy. And that is exactly what the Sanatana Dharma said, Shakti. And the man who found out this quantum physics, Hans Peter Durer, the director of Max Planck Institute, said E is equal to M. Energy is matter, matter is energy. And he called it as a duality. There is no duality between energy and matter. Matter is energy, energy is matter. He has written an article for you. Go to the internet and say, put Hans Peter Durer, H-A-N-S Peter P-E-T-R D-U-D-U-R-R. And write, matter is not made out of matter. Matter is not made out of matter. This matter is not made out of matter. It's made out of energy. And that's the message he was trying to give. Then he says in that article, I look like a small child in front of the Indian yogis of yore, who called this as Advaita. And they describe the whole of quantum physics in one stanza in the Upanishad. He says, Bahir antascha bhutanam, it's inside and outside of everything. Charam acharam eva cha, it's moving, but you look solid, you all look solid. There's nothing solid about your bundle of jumping leptobox energy. But you look solid, that's called what he calls as Wirklichkeit in German, which Shankara calls as Maya. And then he says, Sukshmavati avijnayam, it is so subtle that no vijnana, no science can find out. Even today, nobody has seen an electron, you can't see an electron. Then it says, Durasam, if you don't know, you don't know. Now, till now, you didn't know what quantum physics is. Cha, Aniketa, Cha, Tattva, when you know it is inside you, it's so close. If you know this, you know the whole human being is energy. And that is otherwise called your consciousness, which you call Atma. Then somebody says, where is the Atma? Atma is everywhere. In the philosophy, Indian philosophy, they say, what is Atma? You take a small little vessel, pot, let's say a mud pot. What is inside the mud pot? Energy or the space. What is outside? Space. Now, when a man dies, what happens? You just break the pot. What has happened? The Atma, the space inside has become part of the space outside. So you become one with the universe. As simple as that, it's all energy. If you understand this, yoga becomes meaningful. Very easy to understand. Yoga is you change your energy pattern from the sympathetic mode to parasympathetic mode. We have been doing a lot of foolish things in Western medicine. Like for example, we say whenever somebody gets a heart attack, we do an angiogram because there's money in it. Then we do an angioplasty and bypass surgery because there's money in it. But none of these things have anything to do with heart attack. Actually, America, they did a research study, very interesting study. They took angiograms of everybody who came. And then single vessel disease, no, they didn't know anything. Left them alone. But then they said, this man might get a heart attack because it's blocked. And would you believe in the next 15 years when they saw, if any one of these people had a heart attack, they had a heart attack, nothing related to that vessel at all. It's far away, somewhere else. Then they found the most important cause of heart attack is that we becoming I, you know, you becoming arrogant and sympathetic and becoming just parasympathetic, it removes the chance of a heart attack. So being a very good yogi like Rajendra, you can't get a heart attack, can't afford to get a heart attack because heart attack is a parasympathetic sympathetic activity. So if you are a fully parasympathetic like him, you can't get a heart attack at all. Good for him. I wish he doesn't get a heart attack. So yoga simply means becoming a sympathetic human being who is always angry, who is like a lion roaring, to a lamb. Now that doesn't mean you don't work. As your Pro Vice Chancellor rightly said, work is very important. Now education, unfortunately in India, follows the Western education again. There you believe what the teacher says, you don't question the teacher. This is very important, I tell you. We have become so naive in these days. I had a cousin brother of mine, this boy had some neck pain. He was going neck pain. And then one day he slept and fell, and then he fell on the same side. So the neck pain became so severe that he couldn't move. So I asked one of my physiotherapists to see him. So he said, sir, I have talked to him. I said, yes, I have almost cured him, sir, he said. I said, why? I talked to him and I found out what is his problem. His problem is not in the neck. It's in the trapezius muscle. He has got a very spasmodic muscle which has got a band. So bad, sir, it is. And it can be rectified in 2 days. I have given him some exercise. And lo and behold, the boy is absolutely fine now. 15 years he has with me. Now it's gone. That's the power of physiotherapy. Because it is only physiotherapists who examine the patient. We doctors don't examine the patient now. With the minute you see a patient, you say cat talk, cat scan, dog scan or pet scan. But you don't examine the patient. If you examine the patient, you see this band in the muscle, which you don't see. And you take an x-ray. If you take an x-ray, your x-ray is as old as you are. So there will be some specules in the bone. So you say spondylitis, which simply in Latin saying pain in the neck, that's all. I always tell them, you are a pain in the neck, it's not pain in the neck. Because the pain in the neck is not due to the bone, but due to the muscle which is spasmodic. The muscle which holds it. And that's the cause of the pain. And this is how we have to understand the whole thing and question ourselves. That's the only way you learn. And science is not just following what the Vedas said. B.Sc., M.Sc., and Ph.D. No. Science is inquiry. You have a doubt in your mind and try to get an answer to that doubt from as far as we can go. And that's called real science, which we don't do. And according to the science, yoga should be the ideal thing for all illnesses to go away, because it converts you from a sympathetic mode person to a parasympathetic mode person. That's all, as simple as that. And Rajendra, of course, is an expert in the field and he'll talk to you about it. But I'm not an expert, but I understand yoga. He understands yoga. You know the difference between the two? Now this hall, we all see, he sit here. We understand the hall. It's a big hall and it's got the air conditioner, fan, this, that and all. If you overstand, you take a helicopter and go above and look at this, looks like a small little speck. So you overstand the idea. When you overstand a thing, you understand really what it is. So yoga is very simple. It's nothing to really go about, grave about and do Western type of RCT research to say, I did this research in yoga, that research in yoga. No. You simply have to, how many people you have converted into human, good human beings, you are a good yoga teacher. And what is a good human being? That's the correct thing. You must have a healthy mind. Where is the mind? Never mind. Where is the mind? It's your lock, no? Let's see. It's a very simple question. Where is the mind? My friend with beard.
In our body.
In our body. Okay. Where is the mind, young lady? With the dupatta around her neck. Where is the mind? You all learn science. Where is the mind? Yes? Somebody say something from this side. Brain. Brain. Yes. Mind is in the brain, right? That's what the psychiatrist will tell you. If you have a mental illness, he'll give a chemical drug to affect the brain. So you become a complete zombie after that. A professor of psychiatry in New York, young lady, her name is Grace Elizabeth Jackson, she found out that we are damaging the human brain by psychiatric drugs. And she wrote a book called Crime on Mankind, Dementia, Crime on Mankind by Doctors. Because we give drugs and make him demented and then call him Alzheimer's. Alzheimer's is a disease produced by us by giving chemicals. Mind is the brain. Yes, this lady has read her book very well. There was a Canadian neurosurgeon called Wilder Penfield who, while operating on awake patients, you know, brain injury, you don't anesthetize the patient, awake patients you operate. He was tickling the various parts of the brain with the electric loop and it was noticing different changes. So he said, aha, the brain must be the seat of the mind. So he wrote, brain is in the mind. So now we follow the brain is the mind, brain is the mind, brain is the mind. The same fellow, after observing so many patients, said, I'm sorry, in 1971 he wrote a paper, Wilder Penfield. I'm sorry, I said the brain is in the mind. Mind is in the brain. But brain is too small an organ to hold the brain, mind, which is too big, so vast. And my mind is the consciousness. That's your energy. And it's not in the brain. It's, as somebody rightly said here, it's all over the body. Your leg is also mind. So if you all the time worry about your leg, and if you think all the time you will get a cancer in the leg, concentrate on that. One day you will get cancer in the leg. So don't get frightened of anything, because your concentration on that area makes you get the disease. You are inviting the disease. So yoga is a very good panacea for most illnesses, which is cheap, effective, and it doesn't have side effects. The only side effect, it makes you a good human being. So the healthy mind is a mind with enthusiasm to work hard and mind with an enthusiasm to be compassionate. The day you have these two qualities, you become a human being, and that must be the aim of our education. Today's education is to make a wealthy career. Every education says, I must make my physiotherapist ready for a job. They don't say, I must make my physiotherapist a good human being so that he can serve society for the rest of his life. Nobody bothers about that. This is also the Western idea that you have got, that education is meant for a job. So I always tell them, education is meant for making a human being, a healthy human being with a healthy mind, not just a wealthy career. And if you did that, everybody will be a yogi automatically. You don't have to do yoga. So friends, in short, yoga is a very simple Indian ancient method of transforming a sympathetic man into a parasympathetic man, where he is very compassionate. Converting an I illness into wellness, we. We. Because you are not one human being, you can't say I. You are a colony of 120 trillion human beings, small, small cells. Each one of them is a human being. And that is said part of your first cell that you are made in the mother's womb, the zygote. You are one cell even you are made in the mother's womb. And today you become a 60 kilograms big man. And you think you are a big man. No. You are the same one cell as divided into 120 trillion cells. Each one of them capable of doing all that you are doing. So they are a colony, loving one another so much. And you must see in a biophoto on camera, if you see how they are happy and dancing with each other. And why are they happy? Because they love others. When will you be happy? When you love all else in the world. Compassion. So compassion is the thing that really makes you what you are. And compassion is because your cells love each other, your cells love other cells, so you can't hate anybody. If you hate, your cells get confused. Says, well, I love everyone, why is this man hating? So if you still go on hating, because there are some people taking hatred all their lives, then the other fellow says, my God, this fellow is hating everyone, so let us hate each other. So they hate each other in your body. And that's the beginning of autoimmune disease, where your own body cells destroy your own body cells. Remember that? So far modern medicine didn't know what is autoimmunity. Now we know. If you hate others, they'll hate you. So do not hate. Love everyone. And if you love everyone, you live well. So live well, love others. You want to be happy, right? All of you want to be happy. I'll give you a small mantra of happiness. Make another man happy in this world. You will see happiness all the time. Don't try to make yourself happy by doing so many things. You'll never be happy. Try and pick up a man who is unhappy and give him some solace and see that he is happy. You will be always happy. Have you tried that, young lady? She say yes. Right. So your mind can be transformed by yoga from illness to wellness. And that is where all of you are important. And you physiotherapists are very important. Till I got a small stroke 6 months ago, I didn't know I was not thinking much of physiotherapy. But I now know they are the ones who made me from the horizontal position to the vertical position. And they are the ones who made me what? And your positive thoughts. Never give a negative thought to a patient. Don't tell him you will not be able to do this. Say you will be able to do it and he'll be able to do it. I have all my doctors, all my nurses, all my physiotherapists were my students. Because I have been teaching for 20 years. And when I had the stroke, I thought the end has come. I was so depressed and I was lying down in the bed in the hospital and seeing people walking outside on the veranda. I used to be jealous of them. They are able to walk, I am not able to walk. So one day my neurosurgeon came. He is a very good student of mine. Murli Pai is his name. So I came, I said, Murli, where am I won't be able to walk. So he said, sir, you will walk, sir. I said, no, yeah. No, he said, no, sir. Next week you will walk better than them. I said, what are you talking? If you don't walk next week, I will stop doing neurosurgery and sit with you and talk to you. He's a very famous neurosurgeon and doing very good work. If he is so confident that he will stop neurosurgery if I don't walk, you will be surprised. The next day I walk. The previous day my physiotherapist had to hold on to me like a big bundle falling down. Next day I walked, she was shocked. She said, sir, you are today able to walk. I am not assisting you. I said, yes, because my student gave me energy and my enthusiasm. So always talk positive things to your students, to your patients. And you will be able to help a lot of people. And another very interesting thing about physiotherapy is pain therapy. In pain, we doctors use painkillers. The biggest chillers, painkillers damage the kidney and produce kidney damage. Painkillers give heart attack up to 5 years in the next. But physiotherapy doesn't give either kidney failure or heart failure. It's a very good method. So try and do that, and by using your age-old methods of physiotherapy. Good luck, Godspeed, and you will all enjoy our great friend Rajendra, who is a phenomenon in Australia and a phenomenon all over for yoga. And he will enjoy his new yoga techniques, which will make you still better. I'm told you have the basic yoga training already. And you will become now postgraduates. So far you are only BBT yogis. Now after seeing you, Rajendra, you will become MPT yogi. Good luck, Godspeed. And I was very happy to see our future vice chancellor, so called pro vice chancellor, you know, pro insulin. It's a pro insulin that becomes insulin. So he's a future vice chancellor of Nitte University. And I'm very happy, he's a good friend of mine. I'm very happy to see him. And he's very energetic, enthusiastic, and gave a wonderful speech. He said, I'm not a specialist, I'm not this, I'm not that. But he is everything. And he is humble. You know, I always consider somebody's education by the humility that he has, not by the degree that he has got. Even a PhD who is arrogant, he is an idiot. But a SSLC who is very humble, is highly educated. So here is a plan who is the ideal thing for the future of Vice-Chancellorship. And I wish him well. Godspeed, good luck to all of you. Do well. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for enlightening us with your encouraging words. We have Sri Rajendra Yenganamore as the resource person for today's function, who is the founder of the Vasudeva.